Please. We talked about this.
Yes, but the door was open, so I assumed. Captain Rogers wished to know when Mr. Stark was arriving.
Thank you. I'll be right there.
I'll use the door. Oh, and apparently he's brought a guest.
We know who it is?
I apologize. Well, I suppose, yes, I did intend to come in here.
And now?
And, well, whatever is your preference.
Rakoff kills you, one of the big ones comes to avenge you.
Wait, what are the big ones?
Well, I doubt the god from space has to take an ibuprofen after a fight.
Oh, classic.
I've already sent a car ahead to Busan for you. Who are you taking with you to Korea?
Okoye. And Nakia as well.
You sure it's a good idea to take your ex on a mission?
Yes. We'll be fine. Besides, you'll be on a call should we need backup.
I have great things to show you, brother. Here are your communication devices for Korea. Unlimited range. Also equipped with audio surveillance system. Check these out. Remote access Kimoyo beads. Updated to interface directly with my send table.
It is funny because of the grievous injury the man just suffered.
No, he's not really injured.
Ah. Wanda, I don't presume to know what you're feeling. But I would like to know.
You think that would bring me comfort? It's seeing him again.
Jarvis, could you kindly vacuform a digital wireframe made of manipulable projection?
...1974 Stark Expo model scan complete, sir.
How many buildings are there?
Am I to include the Belgian waffle stands?
That was rhetorical, just show me. What does that look like to you, Jarvis? Not unlike an atom. In which case, the focus. Over here. Highlight the unisphere. Those footpaths. Get rid of them.
What is it you're trying to achieve, sir?
I'm discovering, I'm rediscovering a new element. Loose the landscaping, the shrubbery, the trees, parking lots, exits, entrances. Structure the protons and the neutrons using the pavilions as a framework.
Get our hands on one of these things.
The last one is at Fort Meade, behind three guarded gates and a 12-inch steel wall.
Shouldn't be a problem.
Is this back, Malon? Khalid Kandil mission. How was you? He didn't say he was a pararescue.
Is this right?
Heard they couldn't bring in the choppers because of the RPGs. What'd you use, a stealth shoot?
No. These. I thought you said you were a pilot.
I never said pilot.
The question is, who at S.H.I.E.L.D. could launch a domestic missile strike?
Pierce.
Who happens to be sitting on top of the most secure building in the world?
He's not working alone. Zola's algorithm was on the moon during the start.
So is Jasper Sitwell.
So the real question is, how do the two most wanted people in Washington kidnap a S.H.I.E.L.D. officer?
The answer is, you don't. My understanding, Danya is like a pillar of the community, right? So when I was a kid, my titi passed away.
Your titi?
Yeah, my titi, yeah.
Who is your titi?
But when I was a kid, my aunt passed away. And the entire neighborhood got together for a ceremony. It's like a week long. Maybe they're doing the same thing for Danya.
Worth a shot.
Nexus events happen when someone does something they're not supposed to do, right? Great. And then that thing they're not supposed to do cascades into a whole range of other things that aren't supposed to happen, and so on and so forth, until eventually a new timeline branches. Yes?
I'm sorry, you're saying there's a multiverse?
Because I thought that was just theoretical. I mean, that completely changes how we understand the initial singularity. We're talking about an eternal inflation system, and how does that even work with all the quantum? It's insane.
Sorry. It's really cool.
Could be a meteor, it could be a volcano, a supernova. If everything and everyone around you is destined for imminent destruction, then nothing that I say or do will matter. Because the timeline's not going to branch. Because it gets destroyed.
Why do you always do that thing? Do what? That thing you do when you're fighting. And the... like the... This thing that you do when you whip your hair when you're fighting with the arm and the hair and you do like a fighting pose. It's a... yeah. It's a fighting pose. You're a total poser.
I'm not a poser.
Oh, come on. I mean, they're great poses, but it does look like you think everyone's looking at you.
I'm not sure. You're not vibranium. Chitauri?
Not like any alien tech I've seen. How long did your dad have them before he gave them to you?
About 1,000 years?
Their thermoluminescence indicates they're older than that, by a lot.
Neutralize a lot of threats before they even happen.
But the punishment usually came after the crime.
We can't afford to wait that long.
He's weak.
After New York, I convinced the World Security Council we needed a quantum surge in threat analysis. For once, we're way ahead of the curve.
By holding a gun to everyone on Earth and calling it protection.
You know, I read those SSR files. Greatest Generation? Yes, this is nasty stuff.
Yeah. We compromised. Sometimes in ways that made us not sleep so well. But we did it so that people could be free. This isn't freedom. This is freedom.
S.H.I.E.L.D. takes the world as it is, not as we'd like it to be. It's getting damn near past time for you to get with that program, Captain.
Don't hold your breath.
Almost everyone in this room has had an encounter with at least one of the six Infinity Stones.
Or substitute the word encounter for damn near been killed by one of the six Infinity Stones.
Well, I haven't. But I don't even know what the hell you're all talking about.
Thor, what do you know?
Is he asleep?
No. I'm pretty sure he's dead.
Where to start?
The ether, firstly, is not a stone. Someone called it a stone before. It's more of a kind of an angry sludge sort of thing. So someone's going to need to amend that and stop saying that. Here's an interesting story, though, about the ether. My grandfather, many years ago, had to hide the stone from the dark elves. Scary being. So Jane, actually. Jane is an old flame of mine. She stuck her hand inside a rock this one time, and then the ether stuck itself inside her, and she became very, very sick, and so I had to take her to Asgard, which is where I'm from, and we had to try and fix her. We were dating at the time, so you know, I got to introduce her to my mother. The only thing that...
Why don't you come see
me? I'm not done. The only thing that is permanent in life is impermanence.
Awesome.
Excellent to know. I like a Bloody Mary.
Thank you.
I guess when you said you'd do it yourself, you meant you'd do it yourself.
You are not used to the truth, are you?
I got a look at your suit, vibranium weave. I'm very impressed. You realize that this puts you under the Accord's jurisdiction.
How long do your psychological evaluations usually take?
Why, you bought it?
Not currently. Yes, Ms. Romanoff. I'm sure I have much to learn.
This guy, his connections with rebel organizations all over Eastern and Central Europe, and he's strong. Too strong.
And?
Well, he's been connected to this online group called the Flag Smashers. Now, Red Wing traced them to a building somewhere outside of Munich, so that's where I'm going.
Well, I don't trust Red Wing. Hold on a minute.
You don't have to trust Red Wing. But I'm gonna go see if he's right. Because I have a feeling they might be a part of the Big Three.
What Big Three?
The Big Three.
What Big Three?
Androids, aliens, and wizards.
That's not a thing.
That's definitely a thing.
No, it's not.
Every time we fight one of the three.
So who are you fighting now, Gandalf?
How do you know about Gandalf?
I read The Hobbit in 1937, when it first came out.
So you see my point?
No, I don't. There are no wizards.
Dr. Strange
is a sorcerer.
A sorcerer is a wizard without a hat. Think about it, right? I'm right. I just came up with that. It's crazy. But look, that's not the point. These guys aren't magical. All right? They use brute force, just like you. The incredibly annoying guy in front of me with the staring problem.
believe this. I was actually having a really good day today, you know, Mr. Stark. Didn't miss my train. This perfectly good DVD player was just sitting there, and algebra test. Nailed it.
You know what I think is really cool? This webbing. Tensile strength is off the charts. Who manufactured that?
I did. It's like my senses have been dialed to 11. There's way too much input, so they just kind of help me focus.
You're in dire need of an upgrade. Systemic, top to bottom. 100-point restoration, that's why I'm here. Why are you doing this? I gotta know, what's your MO? What gets you out of that twin bed in the morning?
Because I've been me my whole life. I've had these powers for 6 months. Mm-hmm. I read books, I build computers. And yeah, I would love to play football. But I couldn't then, so I shouldn't now.
Sure, because you're different.
Exactly. But I can't tell anybody that, so I'm not. But you can do the things that I can. But you don't. And then the bad things happen. They happen because of you.
So you want to look after the little guy, you want to do your part, make the world a better place, all that, right?
Yeah, just looking after the little guy. This way it is.
Big vocal stress patterns, adrenaline spikes.
None of that was in the schematic we launched.
He had a self-constructed learning spiral.
In his language database, he was supposed to learn slang, not go insane.
You're assuming it did.
Look, we both know the guy has anger issues, which not to point a finger.
We told him to solve the world.
all over the globe. Robotics labs, weapons facilities, jet propulsion labs, reports of a metal man or men coming in and emptying the place.
Fatalities?
Only when engaged. Mostly guys left in a fugue state going on about old memories, worst fears, and something too fast to see.
That's kind of a mixed message.
Is it? If it was my mission, world peace, I'd probably take out Strucker too. Could be pulling planes down from the sky. What if he's just doing what he's supposed to?
Let me know if he leaves any more messages.
Is that Paprikash?
I thought it might lift your spirits.
Spirits lifted.
In my defense, I haven't actually ever eaten anything before, so... Wanda? No one dislikes you. Oh, you're welcome. No, it's an involuntary response in the amygdala. They can't help but.
Are you?
I make them look sympathetic.
I used to think of myself one way. After this, I am something else. I'm still me, I think. But that's not what everyone else is.
Don't worry about the wolf. Keep the nightlight off. It's a negative. Answer to you. Yes, ma'am. Gotta go.
Girlfriend.
Any of your old contacts come through?
Still waiting.
Wait faster.
You got a passport?
No, I don't even have a driver's.
You ever been
license.
To Germany?
No.
Oh, you
are. I can't go to Germany.
Why?
I got homework.
I'm pretending you didn't say that.
No, I'm being serious. I can't just drop out of school.
Might be a little dangerous.
I don't drink tea. What do you drink? I don't tea.
It's time for me to be who I am, love, and who I'm supposed to be. But you're a leader. That's who you are.
Thank you.
rest of the raw materials Agent Barton can get his hands on pretty easily. Only major component he still needs is a power source, a high energy density. Something to kickstart the cube.
When did you become an expert in thermonuclear astrophysics?
Last night. The packet. Selvig's notes. The extraction theory papers. Am I the only one who did the reading?
Does Loki need any particular kind of power source?
He'd have to heat the cube to 120 million Kelvin just to break through the Kulun barrier.
Unless Selvig has figured out how to stabilize the quantum tunneling effect.
Well, if he could do that, he could achieve heavy ion fusion at any reactor on the planet.
Finally, someone who speaks English.
Is that what just happened?
They're the two completely different powers, actually. Illusion projection involves depicting a detailed image from outside oneself, which is perceptible in the external world. Whereas duplication casting entails recreating an exact facsimile of one's own body in its present circumstance, which acts as a true holographic mirror of its molecular structure. But, you already knew that.
We're getting access tonight on all basic information streams.
Yeah, well, you guys are definitely off the Pentagon's Christmas list. Every country with a nuke is fighting a cyber attack. War Machine is being deployed to the Middle East in case certain people start blaming each other instead of you.
Okay, well, hold that thought. Let me overnight you a new encryption drive for your suit.
Gotcha. Thanks.
You hear something. We need to hear it, too.
Hey, that goes both ways. Watch your six.
You too.
Any help from on high?
Goes either away from his post or he's been ordered not to answer.